It is a big picture and it is available at scaledagileframework.com. This picture is showing three layers. It is showing portfolio layer, program layer, and a team layer. And this picture talks about that business strategies will come here. There should be a process. There are people who owns the business strategies, business level epics. So they have a term called strategic themes and business epic owners. So for example, if I have a job site and I'm thinking of taking this job site to mobile. So this is my business epic. That okay, I want to make a mobile app for my www.com. Now this epic will have some business case, a lightweight business case which justifies that it is good to go with this particular thing. Then you are not alone. There could be a multiple such epics, or even you might have 2-3 epics like this. So you should have some process to evaluate which epic should go forward. So they implement Kanban at this level. So Kanban with the multiple stages, they talk about that, okay, we have something in ideation stage, something in the review stage, something requires an analysis, then we goes into a portfolio backlog, then an implementation. So we have a portfolio backlog. So some themes, the epics which get approved, which pass through that, they comes and start lying in a portfolio backlog. So it is like not yet, the project has not yet started. The work has not yet started, even though they have a problem with the term project also. They don't believe in project. Now this looks odd, even if we are PMI, REPs and PMI followers, but they don't believe in projects. So I will come to that. So what they use in order to replace the project. Now once we have this portfolio, we will have a budget allocation for these portfolio epics. And according to the budget and their priorities, they use some prioritization techniques at this level as well as at lower level. It will get allocated to agile release trains. Now this is a new name, new vocabulary for all of us. So till here it was okay. Okay, there is a portfolio, it's a generic term. There is a Kanban board, there are some flow management. Agile release train is this. 50 to 100 plus people, 125, 130 people. Means a group of individuals who are working together to achieve program goals. So agile release train should be created according to value stream. So what they use is, for example, your organization dealing with mobile apps. So you may have one team which may range from 50 to 100 people who works on mobile apps. So that is your train, and that train will take all mobile apps related thing. There you may have a dedicated team which is taking care of value stream depending upon your segment of business. For example, you may have created a segment retail, so you may have a retail segment team like a vertical. So anything which is related to retail goes to that. So that's a release train which is running the retail thing. So according to the characteristics of various release trains, this work will get allocated to them. Now usually business epic may go to only one train, but it, in some cases when the epic is big and the division is separate, you may end up allocating one epic to multiple teams. So you may have a team of release teams also. So where the situation becomes more complex. So that is a possibility, but let's not get into that as of now. So what we have thought of, that we have a group of individuals, big group of individuals who can take big programs. And if we have an approved work, we can allocate to them. Okay, now this release train takes us at the program level. So this one was portfolio level decision. That okay, this work worth spending money, and we have this much money. These are our goals, this is our business case. Let's allocate this train to it. So they have decided that this train can pick up, or this group can pick up this work. Now we have a program level, the second level. The program level is all about agile release train management. You can, simple level you can think of. So whatever happens at this particular level, 50 to 125, 140 people level, is all about train. Now, this segment has practices which helps us in doing program management, where the goal of this layer is integrating work done by the teams. And the third layer is our normal agile team. So normal agile teams remains here. They will be working here only. But rather than working on iteration and iteration, they will work on iteration and iteration, but they will work with the release planning. They will work with the program level planning, which is done along with these two layers. So since we had a problem related to delivering working software frequently, since we had a problem of managing changes, all these things we were talking about, meta scrum, scrum of scrum, hierarchy of product owners, hierarchy of scrum masters, those whole hierarchy sits here. Everybody sits here. So we have a chief scrum master, which is called here release train engineer. So this release train is managed by release train engineer. He is more or less like a chief scrum master. Even in a documentation, they declare it as a chief scrum master. And then this all planning related discussion is done by release management. Release management takes care of that program train is on track, train whatever dependency, whatever issues related to program level increment is there, is handled by this group. So RTE is part of it, but other business people, portfolio representation may come into program management, product management people will be part of release management. Content decisions, now this is a managed planning and execution decisions. What about the scope? What about the content? Content is managed by another group or individuals, which is called product management. So you have like chief product owner, it could be multiple people. So unlike Scrum, we don't dictate that there has to be one product owner only. Here you can have multiple people who in collaboration may take a role of product management. What is their role? Their role is thinking about program increment. Now, they talk about two layers. So one layer is, we can think of, it's, let's visualize like, say we have a one iteration, second iteration, third iteration, fourth iteration, and fifth iteration, and after that we will have a program increment. So these people, the middle level people, are focusing here. What will we get after a quarter? What will we get after 2 months, 3 months, whatever frequency you decide? They talk about like 5 to 8 is a 5 to 8 iteration is good range, but you decide that. Okay, now team would be working here as they were working before. But they need to ensure whenever they are planning their thing, they are in line with PI objectives. So at a middle layer, we create program level objective. Means for my release train, for next duration, say 10 week duration, if I am running 5 sprints, I should achieve this objective. Now rather than talking about detailed scoping, we talk about objective. Means there is some level of flexibility which is available. Objective should be met. So we are not telling that the screen should look like this, etc., etc. At a program level, it is done by a program objective. And we have a program backlog. So program, we pick things for a program increment from a program backlog. Program backlog is made on the basis of portfolio backlog. So there was a portfolio backlog. The stories got split. They came into program backlog. And program increment is planned as per program backlog. Now, program backlog is a collection of features. So they talk about epic features and story theme hierarchy. Here you have majority of features. In some cases, you may have a program level epics also. There could be some big epics also, which may lie here. Once you have it, you do a release planning meeting where everybody is invited, which is expected to be like 100 plus people attending, 2 days meeting, and that is recommended in a safe as a must. Like everybody should be co-located, and should be a big meeting, and at the end of the meeting you should be coming up with a program level objectives. And inside that program level objectives, you play Scrum.
Would that not be very expensive in a distributed environment?
Yeah, but they find it, it adds a lot of value because of the complexity. So they find it that, the good part is, it would be an expensive, a lot of time it becomes a challenging because allocating people for 2 days, and that is also flying from a different geography. The recommendation from SAFE is at least in a first release meeting, make sure everybody is included. In a subsequent meetings, you may take some distributed platform in use where somebody is not physically attending, may attend from virtual mode. But the idea is that is the only important meeting which will guide you for next 5-6 weeks. 10-12 weeks.
Mm-hmm.
big portfolio definitely had travel budgets as well.
Yeah, so it's a that is the goal. That is how it is managed. And at a lower level, it's our same Scrum team. And we do have a product owner here who decides team level backlog. So they have a hierarchy of backlog. We have a portfolio backlog, we have a program backlog, we have a team backlog. And they are linked. So team would be working on a team backlog, which is expected to be user stories. So they would be working on user stories, delivering user stories. They will deliver values via user story. Program will deliver value at the end of program increment, 5-6 sprints, features. And at the end of release chains, we would be releasing, say, business ethics. We would be meeting business ethics. Yeah, yeah.
This product management people, they would be coming from somewhere from the people who are responsible for the portfolio backlog?
Yeah, so what they talk about that there are different responsibilities. So portfolio backlog is usually handled by Epic owners and lean and agile leaders. Product management, you can think of that once the product roadmap has been achieved or discussed. Now, grooming the product roadmap and meeting those business case ideas is the role of product management. And ensuring that all teams, from a content point of view, from a requirement point of view, remain aligned to that goal,
right.
Business goals.
So, I mean, this product management people should be somewhere involved earlier
in,
also.
In between, yes. Somewhere involved, and they are like middle path.
That's why they can be owner of that program.
True. And they are the one who are transferring this to this level. So, and they also remain with these guys, so they don't deviate, remain in the feature boundaries.
Product manager, it's two questions here. We have a product manager per release train, and this product owner for one particular release should roll up into the product manager also.
Yeah, so what they talk about, you may, one product management may handle two product owners, okay? Yeah, and team level person is a product owner, our traditional product owner, and he's more like a business analyst here, who is focused on elaborating things and ensuring the team is aligned with the goals. This guy is there, talk about like if you have more team, like 2-to-1 ratio.
Mm-hmm.
So if you have more, then you may need more product management here.
And also this DA people.
So, one second. So you explained that hierarchy of product owners. So the lowest level product owners or the representatives will be here, and the higher level is there. It could be one or more people,
yes,
for a release train.
And then they integrate with the business guys, because here also there is a business owner who is the stakeholder who is giving them a feedbacks. They have to make sure business owner is satisfied. So business owners like vertical head, marketing head, whoever owns that particular value stream.
So their role starts only when an item is taken from the portfolio backlog and assigned to them.
Yes, so their main work is grooming program backlog. So if you talk about in our technical language, they own the program backlog. And program backlog get initiated when we have something here and when we have a release train here.
We don't call them program managers as such.
Yes. So in many organizations, product management role also called program management. But now here there is a problem also, because RTE also sometimes called program management. Because the release train engineer may also become a program manager. But this is something like the skill needed here is coordination program management, content level product management. So they are more near to product management rather than program management. Here, if you want to have a traditional profile, you say product manager. And this is the program manager.
So RTE is program manager. They manage the roadmap then.
Yes, product manager.
What is going to...
Yes.
So
yes.
This BA or the product owner, yahan pe jo hota hai,
yeah,
team level pe.
Yeah.
So somewhere we would meet an objective, not the detail, but detail level details we chahiye hoga to wo
ye karega. So what is like, we have a Kanban, we have a business epic, then it is a program features or program epics, and program features will get splitted into user story, invest user stories, and the BA, he will make the invest user story,
okay.
And team will do a sprint planning as usual.
Acha, so still I don't find anything different from framed is fine. I can take a pen paper and I can start from right from designing a product. Aap le lo, jaise Flipkart ko banana. So wahan se leke, you can start and make a roadmap and do a feature mapping and everything. So I can do this, I can come up at this level, and I may be able to come roll it up at this level. Right. But यहाँ पे जो एक release train का concept है, that is something which is
yeah.
which is
now what is release train? Now, as I said, there is no project here. They believe that let's not do any temporary thing. Do a flow based thing. Means these 50 people will keep working quarter and quarter. You will keep putting the different things to them. Since they are predictable, so they talk about don't plan project. Just plan that every 3 months, whatever some delivery comes. If your delivery was not scheduled in this train, you can catch the next train. So like a metro, which says that when we do a project planning, we plan like an aircraft. Like you need to go to Bangalore, you book the ticket, you do everything. But when you have to catch the train, you don't plan anything. You just go there and there is a frequency. At a frequency, train comes, you board the train. They have a concept like team will work in a cadence. It is a defined time box iterations. They will take priority for a time box iteration. They will finish that in a time box iteration. If you need something else, you put it in the next backlog, next priority.
How do you take care of maintenance and BAU projects?
Yeah, so it is maintenance would be maybe better here in a release train environment.
So something which is emergency, it has to go across these release trains and get into production graphics.
Depends on how do we want
to get a taxi.
Okay, now
you have dedicated teams in
there. Good point. Now point is this framework is basically for designing products, and that is also flow based product designing. Now it is too much influenced by lean, and the lean was basically a manufacturing concept. So they are saying that we are taking principle from lean, but we are moving it to a product development. And they have a book called Product Development Flow, which is written by Donald Reinsertz, and his principles are used as a very guiding factor in this complete implement. So when I will browse through the presentation,
it's perfectly okay when the product is in its this uphill curve. Once it stabilizes and once
maybe you something inspect and adapt, and you may have some way of handling it. Like now the another thing which we do is here also we keep a buffer of one iteration. So when we talk about these iterations, the last iteration is not planned with work. It is planned, it is called innovation and planning. So it is said that some level of buffer, like it's a 2 week iteration, 1 week can be used as a buffer, and the remaining week we should focus on innovation and planning for the next train.
That is what they say, iteration minus one and zero.
Something like that. So they have a structured approach for that. And they do have a prescription of running 2 weeks sprint. Hard and fast. It has to be 2 weeks. It has to be synchronized. Like each team must be synchronized, must be running 2 weeks sprint.
But generally, they say to start with this 3 weeks, they start.
Safe as a prescription. Safe as a prescription. So there are some prescriptions, there are rest of our framework.
Does DevOps have any specific role in this?
No, not a DevOps, but they do have a team called System Team and DevOps Team. No, we have a DevOps name as well. So they talk, such kind of things can be managed by a DevOps team, which is a shared team. It is not necessary, like they, good points, we missed it. Not everybody is sitting on train. There are good number of people who are sitting at a program level. So like UX guideline, architectural runway, system architects. So they will keep working on an architecture runway in advance. They sit at this particular level.
So they are not part of the Scrum team as such?
They are not part of the Scrum team as such. Yes,
okay.
Yes.
That's a differentiator.
So you have a DevOps team, such kind of issues should be handled by. We also have a concept called System Team somewhere coming. There is a System Team also. And this System Team, is a collection of team which takes care of integration related work. For example, you have given your delivery, everybody has given their demo. Now, these all demos has to be integrated, and there has to be a consolidated working software. So now working software has to be happen at two level. One is the team is saying, I am working. Another is the program level, we are saying that we are working. So the program level integration is done by System Team. So a dedicated team just to handle those kind of issues. So you can think of like an integration team, you can think of like issue handling team, and you can create maybe two system team if needed, or more people in a DevOps. So that's an inspect and adapt is always there. So they also keep talking about at a program level we do an inspect and adapt, and at a team level we also do an inspect and adapt. Innovation and planning will have a retrospective for a program level. And each iteration, all Scrum ceremonies are followed. So every sprint you have a sprint retrospective.